gentlemen, and welcome to the Multimedia Showcase Live. We are your hosts, Olivia Tenefoss
and Chris Parker.
In case you didn't know, the Showcase is an event that is hosted by Delaware Tech's Communications Program that showcases the best of student work from the past year. Chris, can you tell us what all we're going to be seeing here tonight?
I sure can, Olivia. So first off, thank you all for tuning in into our live stream tonight and support for this great event today. Tonight, we're going to be seeing students' works from the past two semesters, including photography, podcasting, intro to video, and advanced video. And there will be many more, but I think that's about it for now, right?
Well, the Milton Theater is also going to be selling food and drink, which is really good food. So come on down. It's not too late. The show starts at 7 o'clock. So come to 110 Union Street in Milton, Delaware. And this event only happens once a year. So bring some family and friends for an incredible night to support our students. And it's the atmosphere here is crazy. There's a lot of people. So come on out. Chris, there's also someone we need to give a huge thank you to. Can you tell us who that is?
I sure do. So, huge shout out to Fred Munzert for letting us use the Milton Theater to showcase and for our live streams. It's a great opportunity for students and to, you know, get their work out there for future employers. You know, the Milton Theater shows over 300 events a year in support of things like this to bring the community together and get everything out. But that's all for now from me. We're going to toss it over to Jana, who's going to be talking to some featured artists from Del Tech.
Thank you so much, Chris and Olivia. I'm Jana Rourke, and right now I'm standing here next to Savannah, who's a classmate of mine. So I understand you have a couple of works being shown. Can you tell me the inspiration and what you have being shown here?
I have a, it's like an abstraction kind of thing. So it's a whole bunch of Bohemian Rhapsody ticket stubs kind of like displayed, and there's a picture of Freddie Mercury next to it. And that one I made because I had just seen Bohemian Rhapsody. And I was obsessed with it, and I listened to Queen, I think, on repeat for like a month, so it was great. And then I also did a zombie makeover of myself, which was really fun because I literally just found the weirdest effects on Photoshop and then just kept splattering them on my face, so it looked like a pretty cool zombie, I think.
And did you learn anything from it, from Photoshop or anything?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't know how to use Photoshop before I even took the class and did the project, so that was pretty cool, so I think I know a lot more now. I'm more confident in my Photoshop skills, so yeah.
And how does it feel to have all these people being able to see it here?
Intimidating, because I don't want them to critique them, but I know that's the best way to learn, so.
And do you have a favorite project or memory from the past year?
Probably the Bohemian Rhapsody one, because that one was such a pain in the butt to make, but it turned out pretty good, so I'm really proud of that one.
Well, I hope you enjoy the show and enjoy seeing everything else. Let's take a look at our director, Jack, over here, and we're going to see what he has to say about his favorite short film.
Hello, my name is John Kurtzis. This is my fourth semester at Delaware Tech as a communications
major. All right,
welcome
major. Back, everyone.
And my most memorable moment was probably my first video I did called The Filmmaker's Conscience. It really just taught me how to start with an idea and then go all the way through with it and have it come out exactly as you envisioned. And from that, I've learned how to do all my other projects and really just make what I intended to create. Thanks y'all for watching, and I hope you enjoy the show.
Welcome back, everyone. I am here with Rob Rector, who is the chairperson for our communications program. And you are actually the one that came up with the idea for the showcase. Can you tell us about some of the inspiration and our first few years of doing it?
Sure, absolutely. So we always wanted to do an event that took place outside of the college. We felt that it was really important for students to have that environment that it didn't feel like a school event. And the Milton Theater is just so rich with history. We felt like this was just such a great place for them to showcase their talents and for them to really shine and feel like rock stars on the stage.
And this event is a great opportunity for our students to meet potential employers. Can you tell us your favorite part about that aspect of tonight?
Absolutely. I remember the first year we did this. We're in our fifth year now, and our first year doing this, we had somebody who had five job openings, and they said, "Hey, look, I'd like to talk to students on the spot to hire them." And I think that it gives them a great opportunity to see not just how they present themselves, but to see them in that professional environment is great. It's almost as good as a job interview, you know, because you can get to see them actually working at the very same traits and characteristics that they're looking for as a potential employee.
And what are some of the feelings that you have when you see all the students' works displayed in one room and one night, just all this work put together?
Yeah, it's amazing. Every year I'm continually amazed by the amount of talent that we have here in Sussex County, Delaware, and to see it in one room in so many different areas of communications, it's incredible. It's overwhelming, and I feel like this is so much better than having to give them a test on something. This is a chance for them to actually show the world just how good they are.
Thank you so much for doing this interview with us. I've really appreciated your help with this project and even setting it up 5 years ago. Now we're going to see one of our outstanding students, Natalie Latanzi, and she is going to be talking about a video that she has being featured tonight. And we're also going to be seeing some of our other students and the work that they're being presented tonight. So now we're going to go to Jana Ruark.
Hi, my name's Natalie. I switched into communications this past semester and I've really been loving it. I like all the classes and the people. I think my favorite project was the sequence video project. I got to be very creative and have a lot of fun with it, and mine involves a lot of action and suspense, and I think it's pretty funny. So I hope you enjoy all the hard work we put into the showcase.
You, at me, it's a conversation. And welcome back once again. I'm here with Khadija. So we just talked a little bit about intro to video. So can you tell me about your sequence and what you had in it and what you did to make it?
So basically, we had a sequence project due, and I didn't really know what to do about it. So I decided to use my sister and put her personality in it, her really vain personality, and make it like her getting ready for picture day, but it doesn't go out the way that she expects it. So came out good. It's in the showcase, so it's pretty cool.
And did you learn anything specific from it? Videography, editing?
Definitely the different types of shots, matching things up. Definitely that class has helped me a lot with videography.
And I know you went on a couple of field trips. Can you tell me about that, your experience there?
Yes, we went on a Phillies trip and we talked to a bunch of people from the MLB. It was a really good experience. I feel like Deltek has really helped me personally in going to my next academic level.
And speaking of that, what are your plans after graduating?
I plan on going to Temple University to graduate my bachelor's in communications and hopefully get a job afterwards.
Well, I look forward to seeing more about you and hearing about your future.
Thank you.
Let's take a look at Chris's vignette where he talks about intro to film.
Hi, I'm Chris Parker. I'm a communications student at Del Tech, and I'm coming up on my last couple of semesters, but today I wanted to talk about a project that I really liked and enjoyed, our mise-en-scene project from Intro to Film. We actually got to go out and shoot in different locations, and I personally went to Cape Henlopen with Cassidy Clark, another communication student. We got to shoot for our mise-en-scene project and got to do a whole bunch of things that were really cool, and we incorporated a lot of the things we learned in Intro to Film. But besides that, I hope you all are having a great rest of your night. Enjoy the show.
All right, and I'm back with Brennan Weber, who is a past communication student from Del Tech, who is now furthering his education at UD. So can you tell us about what's going on up at UD?
Yeah, absolutely. Coming out of the Delaware Tech Communications program, I had just an amazing experience between the instructors, Mr. Rector, Ms. Farley, Mr. White, you know, the experiences, knowledge that I learned, you know, it really gave me an advantage going into University of Delaware. And I think that's why I was able to get in and out in 2 years. You know, I was leap years ahead of the other comm students up at UD, so I think just from those experiences alone have really, really helped me. You know, I'm graduating with a bachelor's degree next month, and I really cannot believe it. So this is reality for me now. I'm excited.
Hey, that's awesome, man. I mean, you put in the effort, and we get what you deserve. Yeah, so that's awesome. So, what kind of things are you working on up at UD, projects in mind or things that you're doing for, furthering your career?
Yes. So, right now I'm an audiovisual specialist for the school. It's not as glorious as it sounds. I'm a one-man band where I shoot, edit, send out videos to different departments, and right now I'm working on the most tedious project I've ever had to do. It's the RN refresher program, so it's getting nurses recertified, and it's a non-credit course at UD. I'm learning a lot about like the gastrointestinal systems and stuff like stuff that I've never wanted to necessarily learn about, but you know, in the field of journalism and video production, you learn about some crazy stuff. So that's what I'm doing right now.
Well, I mean, it doesn't hurt to get that experience in other areas, though, right?
Maybe I'll do a side job in nursing.
Yeah, that could be something. It could be something to look at for sure. Yeah. So, what is the biggest thing that you miss about the communications department at Del Tech?
Just the electric environment. You know, every single day when I would come into class, Mr. Rector was always fired up, Ms. Farley was always fired up, and that inspires you as a student to, you know, learn and do stuff on your own, in your own free time. And I think just UD definitely does have that, but the smaller course sizes, the more intimate relationships that we build with our professors at Del Tech, I mean, it's not even comparable anywhere else, and I definitely miss it a lot.
Yeah, I definitely agree. I mean, like, I've talked to a lot of students, and they, you know, they say that here it's a lot better for students to go through and, yeah, you know, get involved with that kind of, you know, ideas from teachers instead of just sitting in class and not learning anything, really, and not getting hands-on experience from things.
Exactly.
Well, hey, thanks for talking with us tonight.
So
I really appreciate it. And for now, we're about to throw it over to Jana, who's going to be talking with Jim and Lauren.
Thanks. That was awesome.
Hey, man. Yeah, no problem. Thank you for doing this.
Absolutely.
Hi, guys. This is Jim Roblero. I'm a communication student here at Delaware Tech. And one of the classes that I've taken so far is Intro to Film. It's one of the classes that I definitely enjoy the most because it's helped me build on my skill at analyzing movies and really looking at the elements to make it what it is. It's a class that I recommend people to take if they're in the communications.
And kind of moved into graphic design and design and t-shirts, and kind of designed what's been our most popular one is the 302 Horseshoe Crab, which started here with the Milton Theater. So,
and what is the story behind that 302 brand and the logo?
So actually I started working with Rob Rector and Rob Waters here for Revival House. They were having a local film festival and some of our students were in it. And they asked me just to see if I could design a t-shirt for locals. So I played around with a bunch of things and just came up with the 302 on the horseshoe crab. And it's just snowballed from there and it's really taken off. And it's pretty cool because people are identifying it as their logo for being locals, not just something I designed.
And I'm going to throw you a little on the spot here, a little plug. Where can I get this 302 apparel?
So we have stuff in four locations right now. The Brush Factory in Lewis, Life Cycle in Milford, a bicycle shop, Amity Coffee Shop in Greenwood, and a women's boutique in Dover called My Roots.
I look forward to getting some of that apparel. And so you've done the showcase for several years, helping students set up their photography displays. How do you think an event like this helps prepare students for after college?
I think it just helps students show them what a professional environment can be with the live stream, with the gallery exhibit, with the photographs. Students do photographs all semester, and when they see it in a frame, in a mat, hanging up with nice lighting on it, it just shows them how you can take it to the next level and really make it professional. Because other than this, you know, there might be a time where students don't really participate in an art exhibit, and we've had a lot of students just kind of get the bug to pursue it and be in more art exhibits because of doing the showcase.
Thank you so much for doing this interview with us. I look forward to walking out on the floor to look at some of those photos. Right now, we are going to see our outstanding student and our host, Jana Ruark, who's going to be talking about some of the field trips that we've taken for this past year.
Hello, my name is Jana Ruark, and this is my fourth and final semester here at Delaware Tech as a communications student. Over the past 2 years, some of my favorite memories have definitely been going on the field trips. From going to New York to take pictures of the landscapes and stuff in Central Park, to going to the Phillies and Sixers to get a behind the scenes look at what it takes to put on an actual broadcast and talk to people in the industry. All this has taught me a lot about my future career and what I can do. I hope you enjoy the show and all the hard work we've done to put this on.
Hi, I'm Cass, and I've been a communications student here at Delaware Tech for four semesters now. One of my favorite classes was Digital Newsroom, which I didn't expect it to be, but it gave me hands-on experience out in the field doing video, editing, interviewing, interpersonal skills, and it was really nice to have that opportunity. One in particular that I really enjoyed was Milton Zombie Fest, and they had an all-day event, and the footage for that came out really great. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the show and what the rest of the comm students have done.
All right, and I'm back again. I'm here with Keith White, who happens to be the department's podcasting instructor. So tell us, Keith, how has podcasting been going this semester?
Podcasting was going great. We have a lot of awesome students who are really creative and came up with different topics than normal. Every semester we do this, I like to kind of push the envelope and go in a different direction. So we had students that are really good about actually coming up with great dialogue and banter between each other, and really creative with the music as well. So it was a neat focus for them.
So I understand that your class had some guest speakers this semester. Can you tell us about some memories from that?
Sure. We have Coach Mike Faber, and he's great. I bring him in as much as I can. He is an inspirational speaker. He also has a podcast of his own. He's located in Georgetown, actually, but he's done things on a national level as well. He's a basketball coach. He's a personal wellness coach, and he got the chance to speak to the students about his time in the media. He also used to have a sports radio show. He's always entertaining. He's always really unpredictable. Then I had the Rehoboth Foodie, who has his own little empire around here. He's got a radio show and a podcast, and he also has, a Cape Gazette article, and then also his website. If you're going to eat around here and come into Rehoboth for a destination, he is the guy you talk to. He's really entertaining as well. He had the students cracking up with his stories, and of course, he wouldn't share, his least favorite restaurant, but, they tried to get him to crack.
Hey, I mean, everyone has a least favorite restaurant, so you'll find it eventually. So how is that kind of influence on podcasting students been benefiting them?
It's one of those situations where it's a new kind of like a new medium again for students. It's a great way to get them used to speaking, to interviewing, because there's no camera, right? You take that camera element out, it becomes a conversation. It's also a great way to add something to your portfolio. If you go and get a job, right, you can say also, in addition to the things I'm bringing to the table, I also know how to do podcasts. So every media company now, even like TV channels, have podcasts because they want you to be able to go in the car, or go on YouTube, to be able to take podcasts anywhere you go. So it really helps, students to kind of broaden their horizons and get something else.
Wow, that is something that I did not know, and it's very interesting. Like, I never thought that, people actually, looked for those kind of specific things, like, even more specific than just, common skills and, but hey, that's good to know.
Right, for you doing this right now, you could actually, if you took podcasting, you could have that to add to your portfolio. You can, because it's the art of interviewing. It's making people entertaining and engaging.
Yeah. So since we're talking about, the things that students are be learning in podcasting, what's your favorite part of tonight?
Of course, I'm biased, but I've heard my students and what they've done. I love coming here. I love seeing, absolutely every year, I love coming up and seeing the short films, the commercials, anything that anyone does, with the visual graphics. I don't get to go to all these other classes, so I like to see what students have done outside of my own. And that always, for me is a highlight. I got to see a certain, person in our department in a certain video with, special effects and perhaps some horns. So, I've gotten to see some neat snippets of things. So it's been really good to kind of have that go on and get a sneak preview. I can't wait to see what tonight brings.
Yeah, I think you'll like tonight, with all the videos that, that you were describing. It's you'll definitely like what's coming forth for your way. But hey, thank you for talking with us tonight, Keith. I really appreciate the conversation, and I learned a lot of new things from you. We're going to be tossing it to the Calliope Project, so let's see what that's about. I think we're done.
A number of years ago, when the theater was dark, a couple who lived in this town bought this building to save the theater. They didn't want to see it torn down or turned into something other than a place where live art would be presented. We came on the scene 4 years ago and partnered with this couple to be able to present live shows once again here in the theater. The next step in that process, in their desire and has been our desire all along, is for us to buy the theater. So there are many components to this. Purchasing this building is the biggest component, obviously. But other than that, we plan to put the balcony back in, which will take us back to almost 500 seated. We're going to redo the entire facade of the theater building, which will be replacing the marquee end to end, which it was at one point, have a working balcony on top of that marquee. In addition to that, the upgrades to the sound system that are required when we add the balcony, and then completely redoing the lighting grid in here, which allows us to do even bigger and better shows that we can bring in that are on national tour.
The Renaissance Initiative is fabulous for the theater. It's going to be so wonderful as they raise the funds to do all the work that they want to do. They're going to bring it back to a lot more of the historic, original things that were in the theater, and also use it for expanding where they need to provide more for the community when they come to the theater.
There's such a historical feeling when you walk in there with the exposed brick walls, and you walk in there and you feel like there has been, you know, just energy that's in that room from decades ago.
I think the Milton Theater has done really, really a lot for the downtown merchants and other businesses in Milton. It's grown so much, the theater itself, that all the people that are coming for the performances are taking advantage of the other businesses downtown now too. And Milton is being put back on the map, so to speak, after not being on the map for so long and being empty for so long. All of the people that come to the theater performances, they see the businesses at night, they see them during the day, and then they can go and they can actually go to those businesses and benefit those businesses as well. So it's all a big community working together.
I'm personally involved with the theater by many years ago. When the Milton Theater opened, my daughter participated in the dance program, and since then she's been interested in the events that goes on. The future I see for the Milton Theater again is growth. I think there'll be, through the initiative and through the growth, through the capital campaign that's being worked on, will be so much more than just Milton. It'll be the county, it'll be the state, it'll be the peninsula wide that people talk about the Milton Theater, and again, the programs and the entertainment that it provides to the community.
Art in all of its forms is so important to embrace in a community. You see educational budgets being sliced and art is usually the first to go. And here we sit in this incredibly quaint, beautiful town that is by the water. It's got all these natural amenities as well. And we have this wonderful historic theater that is sitting centrally located, and it's a cultural hub. I mean, it has the ability to bring the entire town together through art.
I have spent my entire life involved in the arts and entertainment industry. I personally feel, as an artist, that it is vital to us to have art be alive. It's vital to the individual, it's vital to the community, it's vital to our country, it's vital to the world. This venue is an amazing venue. People come in day in and day out and say how the energy just draws them in. That's important that we make sure that stay alive for people to come and be a part of, and for artists to come and be on this stage and share their art from all over the world. I'm asking that you consider becoming a part. It's going to take the individual, it's going to take the community, businesses, corporations, foundations, all of that to make this happen. Will you consider becoming a part?
And we're back. Thank you all for tuning into our live stream tonight. We really hope you've been enjoying everything so far. Our showcase is just about to start, so do not go anywhere.
And we just want to give a big thank you to all of our behind-the-scenes crew, camera operators, and directors, and of course the Milton Theater, because without them, we wouldn't have a place to do this.
And we'd also like to give a huge thank you to our instructors for helping us prepare for this night, and to Chelsea Wooten, who is our lab technician, our chief, our Adobe Fairy, and our 24-hour hotline for all things editing. We are so extremely thankful for this experience. And now we're going to watch a short year-in-review video of all the things that we've done the past two semesters, and then we're going to see our friend Maddie introducing the show. So,
enjoy the show!
I just want to let everyone know that this year's showcase is going to be so insanely good that it's going to blow my wig off.
There's a saying my grandpa used to always say, be careful what you wish for, because it just might come true. What I would do to prove him right. I wish there was more to life than this. But this isn't what I had in mind. Thank you.
that person.
I don't see anything, man. I think you're just tripping.
Why can't I remember anything?
Yo, Chad, what's going on, man? How you doing?
Doing alright.
Hey, look, I need some help with my rehearsal. I need maybe 10-20 minutes. Could you meet me at the theater at like 4 o'clock? Is that cool?
Yeah, right. Awesome, man.
See you then,
I'll
man.
I'll see you
then,
man.
Thanks. Hey, Chad, what's going on, man?
Hey, what's up, Logan?
Dude, thanks for coming. Appreciate it. Alright. I'm gonna start my next scene, alright? Alright, so this is the scene. Where it's run for us, run. All right.
Whoa!
Oh my God! Oh, dude, I think I broke it.
No.
Oh my gosh, dude, you're gonna have to take my part, man. Please. You're gonna have to do it.
In the play?
Yes, you're gonna have to do it.
I can't act.
Everybody that's auditioned for this sucks, man. Can you please do it? Dude, I just broke my ankle.
I'll do it. Right now, we gotta get some help.
Oh my God, okay. All
right. You just sit tight right here. I'll get some help.
Hey, man. You got this, man.
Thanks.
Sorry, Chad.
They diagnosed me with dissociative fugue, but I feel as though it's another reality. My episodes seem to be getting more frequent. I need a new treatment. Meditation seemed to be the new horizon. A few weeks have gone by, though something uneasy has entered my mind. I can't tell if this is a dream, and my thoughts are racing. Every corner screams danger. I keep telling myself, danger is not real. Here goes nothing. My name is Jason, and this is my story.
Thank you.
Hey, neighbor Reno. So looky here. I got myself into a bit of a pickle. Locked my keys in my house. I'm out here now by myself. I was just wondering if I could hang out in here till the whole ball and chain got home.
Sure. Yes. But I'm doing some cleaning, so.
Oh, that's okay. I won't be no bother. Oh, that's.
Like I said, I'm doing some cleaning.
No judgment here, friend.
Just make yourself at home while I do my chores, all right?
Absolutely. I'll be as quiet as a church mouse on Sunday.
Yeah.
I am feeling a bit hungry. Dirtier than my search history. But that's for the confessional, so. St. John and take him to the pearly gates. I wonder if there's... This seems like good reading too. Okay. Oh my lord. Oh, this girl needs Jesus. With all this baggage, she might as well change her name to Delta Airlines. Looks like I'm down here.
Oh, you're gonna think this is funny. First of all, you're a good writer, and the keys were in my pocket the whole time. Oh, isn't that hilarious?
No, it's not.
What do you mean that's
you
not?
Gotta go.
What do you mean? Aren't we friends though?
No, we're not.
I thought we were friends.
No,
we're not.
Time. Bye.
No, I don't actually have a wife. I'm so lonely.
Hey-de-ho there, neighbor. Listen, I seem to have gotten myself into a bit of a pickle-rino, if you know what I'm saying.
I got standards, diamond nail Flanders, Kool-Aid jammer, cookie pack on camera, I got standards, diamond nail Flanders, Kool-Aid.
I had a superpower, I don't think it'd be a cliche one, so I'd probably go with the ability to change the probability of an outcome. As in, if something has a 60% chance of happening, I'd revert that to, I'd make that higher or lower depending on what I'd want at the time.
If I could have any superpower, it would be to swim at unimaginable speeds, so I could break Michael Phelps' world records, and my superhero name would be the Splash.
If I had one superpower, it would be to make anything appear with my mind, because think about it, like, if you need a good grade on a test, you just make it appear. Or if I wanted a sandwich, I'd make the sandwich appear. My name would be Mind Trick.
My superpower would be pyrokinesis, because I like being able to see things burn, because I'm kind of that person who likes to see certain things burn, especially those I don't like. And as for my super villain name, I would probably go with Pyro Man. This being able to set things on fire. I don't know, something cliched.
If I could have a superpower, it would be the power to fill things. And I know that's weird, but picture this. Your bank account's empty? Fill it. Your bed's empty? Fill it. I guess my superhero name would be Philip.
My superpower would be the ability to time travel, because I'd want to fix some certain things in the past, like Super Bowl 41, 2008 NBA Finals.
If I had a superpower, it'd be the power of flight without wings. I would fly on joy, kind of like Peter Pan. Happy thoughts, positive vibes, and my name would be the Flamboyant Flyer. And I would just have rainbows as I fly away.
Okay, Mr. Lucy first.
The man's name is Robert.
Can I get you anything? You okay? You want some water?
I mean, can I get him anything like you ever get up?
Sorry.
Get it. That's not in my job description. I can start fires, I can steal children's tears.
So what made you decide to run for mayor?
I love people. I feel like I want to give back. When I see all the eons of people who have sacrificed so much for me, I want to give back to them and show them that I too am capable of sacrifice.
You know what he was doing before this? He was scaring kids at a carnival. That's how much of a demon he is.
I have to give a small shout out to my assistant and faithful servant, Chelsea. And could you not do that?
Noted. I have a thing called loyalty. That's what I believe in, loyalty.
Traveling, I have to have certain accommodations. I have to have room temperature set just the right level. I have to have my coffee just scalding enough. Not hot enough.
It's literally hot as hell. Literally.
Not hot enough.
Hot enough. Okay. Let's do it.
That's why I have Chelsea.
It's a very glamorous job.
Tell us about your upbringing and your relationship with your father.
Now, look, I said ahead of time, no dad questions. So, you
it's
know,
okay.
Don't take that out on me. Do you realize what you're causing me right now?
Okay. It's
okay.
Right.
Get beaten later, and that's
it's okay.
Fault. I'm going to talk to my attorney.
It's all the same to you. I'm afraid that my tears may actually burn through this desk. So, if we could move on to another question, I'd appreciate that.
I mean,
would you stop clicking?
As the new mayor, what are your goals and what do you plan to do today?
Chris, as the new mayor, it used to be world domination. And with all of your help, we will rise up and we will crush our opponents. Not literally, of course.
Well, This is what voter tampering looks like. Last night, genius has the bright idea. Mind you, he's running unopposed. He's got the idea. He's like, I'm not gonna win. I'm too nervous. So who does he have run out and tamper with the voting machine?
Hey, what are you doing?
Security was all over that place. He told me, oh, it'll be a breeze. Don't worry about it. You'll be fine. Does this look fine to you? Does it?
Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. Oh, yeah.
Hi there, I'm Cass Clark, reporting for The Wire Deltax.
This is Jimmer Blair, reporting for The Wire.
I'm Olivia Tenefoss, reporting for The Wire.
This has been Logan Williams reporting for The Wire.
It's Veterans Day here in beautiful Rehoboth Beach, and we are so excited to go out and talk to some of those who have served you and really appreciate them today.
I turned 18 in October of 1968, and in those days you had 10 days to register for the Selective Service, the draft.
I served from 1991 to 2001 during the Gulf War.
It's always important to honor your nation's veterans because it's those who fought for your freedom.
The Delaware coastal area has grown significantly over the past few years, and growing with it is the restaurant business.
I've been here at the Cottage Cafe since 1999. I did take a leave of absence last year, but I've been with the company for 18 years now.
I've been in the restaurant business for about 15 years, and this restaurant has been open 17 years, so which is very successful.
Just like you see in other places, like the Delaware coastal areas, more and more people gravitate towards the water. And so we've seen that in town, and our town is only about a mile square, but we've also seen that outside of town.
I'm at Amity Coffee Roasters in Greenwood. It's a small cafe, and we're gonna go inside and talk to a few people about the history of Amity.
So Amity was kind of started out of a dream of mine, slash it was already started. It's kind of, to elaborate, my brother-in-law was already roasting coffee as kind of like a hobby, and he was selling to a lot of like friends and family.
I've always loved Amity, even before I worked here, so I was actually a longtime customer for about 2 years and began to know the people, and I loved what they were doing, supporting local business. It's kind of a community hub for Greenwood. This is kind of the only hangout spot, place we kind of have here. So it's close to the library. It's just a nice location. So I started to work here, and I actually graduated from Delaware Tech with a culinary degree.
Grassroots Rescue hosted its Won't You Be My Sweetheart event at the PetSmart in Rehoboth Beach, Delaware on February 9th from noon to 3 p.m.
We do adoption events at local pet stores, you know, PetSmart and some of the other ones in the area.
I transport the dogs to and from the events. This is only my second one, actually.
We are here today because my mom saw on Facebook the adoptions of all these dogs that are here today.
I'm here to adopt the puppy, and her name is going to be Bailey, and this is Bear.
I'm Brent Martin. I don't really produce my music, but I record it. And I kind of interact with people who do production and things like that, and try to network and things and just bring creative ideas to life. I'm making music more consistently now than I ever have, like, you know, putting tracks out week by week and things, because it feels good. For a long time, I was just helping other people, you know. They would come over with their beats or whatever, and I would sit out here and just mix for them, you know what I mean? But it's that same feeling. It's just bringing the creative idea and like seeing their reactions to when that perfect take gets done, and you listen back to it and you hear yourself and you're like, yo, that sounds sick. Just staying motivated, you know. Like, depression and anxiety is something that everybody deals with on some level, but it kind of runs deep for me, and when it comes to just working and needing to maintain and make money for bills, you know, doing music as a hobby when it's not a main source income, it can be stressful. So just pushing through the stress and making music because I like making it and letting that be the reason. There's been periods where I have stopped making music, whether it be writer's block or need to like realign my priorities and things, but it's something that I continuously come back to. So I don't think I've ever thought about giving it up, but I've taken my fair share of breaks. As a musician and as a person, just be okay with being yourself. And I don't think that that's ever a point that you just reach and is you're just okay forever, but just reminding yourself that it's, you know, it doesn't matter what people think, you know.
My name is Jenny Fercucci, and I'm an English teacher at Sussex Tech, and I'm currently the 2018 Delaware State Teacher of the Year. I basically believe that every child has potential for growth and that every child has something to contribute. I also believe that every child should have access to academic rigor. I've always been super strong in the classroom. Like, I don't mince words. I believe in candor. I believe in truth. I believe in honesty. And I've always done that behind closed doors with my kids, but this year was an opportunity to like share it with our state and potentially with the nation. TED said, let's do something to celebrate voice, and they created TED-Ed. It's the very first time that TED has ever created a channel totally and solely for a singular profession. So that's really an honor. And they asked the teachers of the year to go through this masterclass training and then to submit a video. And then they chose three that they wanted to feature, and mine was one of them. So then they took us to New York and said, step on the TED dot and give a speech. And I did, and it was crazy and exciting and amazing. And I got to give it to all of the teachers of the year, as well as some unbelievable advocates, mentors and educators from the city of New York. And so TED is now working on producing it, so it'll be released before the end of the year. The Teacher of the Year program, the purpose of the Teacher of the Year program is to elevate student and teacher voices. There needs to be this better partnership between communities, schools, and kids so that every child can find the growth that she deserves access to. So that's really very much going to be my focus for the rest of my career, is just creating partnerships and working hard on a state and national level to do that.
Hello, my name is Rick, and I'm an avid Netflix user. A few days a week, I'm a sign spinner for Paco's Tacos. It's not easy work, but it's enough for now. I don't really have a preference when it comes to Netflix shows, but if I find it interesting, I'll have it done in a couple of days.
Yeah, we don't see too much of Rick nowadays. All he wants to do is watch Netflix and continue on with those shows he's been watching. Like Bird Box. Or Stranger Things. Or even The Walking Dead. It wouldn't be so bad if he kept to himself, or he just keeps constantly going on and on about this show that he's watching and about how I'm living my life entirely wrong up until this point because I haven't seen that show. Me and the other guys have kind of decided that Rick has a problem. So we decided to have him sit down and talk this through.
So you guys finally wised up and decided to come watch Netflix with me. good choice.
No, Rick, this is an intervention. We're not all here to watch Netflix with you. We just think you might be watching a little too much Netflix.
Too much Netflix? Are you guys crazy? Have you lost it? Netflix is awesome!
That may be true, but switching to an all-ego diet and blindfolding yourself is definitely weird behavior.
Yeah, dude, you're acting crazy.
Guys, I get it. The last couple shows haven't been your cup of tea, but hear this out, all right? All right. Imagine an animated horse, right? Sarcastic, depressed, nothing's okay with him, because he used to be in a family sitcom which was named Horsin' Around. It's hilarious!
Wow, that sounds stupid.
A few moments later.
Hey, stupid, isn't that your friend over there?
Mr. Peanut Butter.
Mr. Peanut Butter.
Hello, jag heter Björn Tholfsen och jag är norskman.
Har du öl? Nej.
Jag är fra en liten gard av Norge och...
Could you speak English so that we don't have to do subtitles for the whole video?
Yeah, sure. Like, I'm a pretty cultured guy. Like, I like music. I like long walks, bathing regularly. Our word for Saturday is Voskdag, which is literally wash day. In my defense, that child is being very rude and interacting with strangers, okay? Like, what if she would have gotten kidnapped or something?
What about the baby?
What baby? Where I come from, that behavior is sometimes normal, I would say, but it's just a little old-fashioned intimidation, you know? Don't mean any harm by it, I just feels natural to me. We settled that one outside of court, so I wouldn't have to go to prison. So, as part of the deal, I had to take anger management classes for a few weeks.
What was that like?
Hey, Dorson.
Hey, Bjorn.
I have brought in a certified therapy cat to help us with our anger management. Is Fluffy. Studies have shown that while petting an animal, specifically a therapy animal, anxiety is reduced. So tonight we will pass Fluffy from person to person, and as you stroke her, feel the anxiety drain out of your body so that you can better share with us your thoughts and your feelings. We'll begin with Bjorn.
Thank you. This is the one.
Hello, sir. Just wondering, have you seen this gentleman?
Yeah, I think I saw him talking to a guy in that house earlier. Yeah, actually, that's the guy right there that he was talking to.
She get out of here. Why are you off to in such a hurry, huh?
Money's business, huh? Bitch! Ugh.
I have a deadline to meet. I'm not playing with you. Where is he?
I was on my way to pick him up with my boat.
Bam!
He's at a dock outside of town. Yeah, hurry up, you can still get him.
Where's that little bastard? I swear I'm gonna wring his neck. Move along, girl. It's no place for you.
I'm not going anywhere, Red. Not without what I came for.
They sent you to get the money? Well, I got news for you, girl.
Hey, Hello? Yeah, hey. I got him, but I didn't get the bag. I think he might have stashed it before I could get to him. Yeah. Give me 24 hours, and I'll be there to collect.
Man's off his rocker, Jeff. He's going off the deep end this time.
No, man, relax. No big deal.
We got a thesis due in 2 weeks. 2 weeks.
Look, man, it's just another project. Just breathe, it'll be fine.
No, it's a thesis, a culmination of what defines us as a director.
Man, you just start with an idea, and then you put your own style into it.
I mean, even that, I don't know where to start.
Well, what about that heist idea you've been wanting to do?
I got you.
Damn, man, I'm so sorry.
Don't worry about it. The exit's right there. We're almost out of here.
Hey, I'll make sure your cut gets to your family.
What do you mean? It's just a flesh wound. I can...
You're a goddamn hero.
It's just my leg, though. John, it's just my... Don't just leave me here.
No, absolutely not.
What? What's the problem? You're the one that suggested the heist idea.
Yeah, it's because I didn't know how this was going to end.
It's a good ending.
No, it's not. I want a whole other idea.
Okay, what if we did your Western idea?
End of the line, Red. Nowhere left to run.
Won't need to run once my ferry boat gets here. Once I'm across this here bay, I'm a free man.
You ain't making it on that boat, Red.
Oh yeah? Who's gonna stop me?
Then you die.
Well, wait, I die? I thought I was the good guy.
No, I'm the good guy.
Why can't I be the good guy?
I look more like a good guy. I'm taller, more handsome. I got a better voice.
I don't see what a voice has anything...
Just forget. I'm sick of these action ideas. What if we went for something different?
Like what?
Rom-com.
I'm done. Get someone else.
What's the problem?
Get someone else to play your roles, okay?
You know what? I will. In fact, I'm gonna do it myself.
Hey. What do you want?
Look, I'm sorry for treating you so poorly. I just really appreciate you more. I made some changes to the script, and I think you'll really like it.
All right, I'm in.
Really?
Yeah, man. Let's make this happen.
All right.
It has been a wonderful night, full of energy and watching all these projects. And of course, we couldn't have done it without all the graduates. Congratulations to everyone that's going to be graduating at the end of this semester.
And of course, we couldn't have done it without the help, full help of our communications department. And where are they?
There they are.